Forever Fabulous, Olivia Newton-John with the Electric Light Orchestra and Xanadu from the 1980 musical film of the same name, in which Olivia starred as the mysterious Kira. Well, that is it for EPOS this week, but I would just like to say before we finish, I was very touched by all your kind emails about my tribute to Her Majesty the Queen last Sunday. I mean, it means a lot to know that you found it comforting and that it resonated with so many of you. So thank you very much for letting me know. My thanks as well to my producer, Jessica Rickson, for her help with that show and obviously with this one. And I will see you again next Sunday at 1 with more show tunes, more movie songs, another onstage mishap, and one of your leading lady choices in Diva Double. I'm Elaine Page, and this is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 3 o'clock. This is Nikki Cardwell. The Labour leader Sir Keir Starmer says he'll reinstate the 45% top rate of tax for the highest earners if elected to power. The change was announced by the Chancellor on Friday alongside a cut in the basic rate of tax and the reversal of a rise in national insurance. Sienna Rogers from the parliamentary publication House magazine says Labour is starting its annual conference in high spirits.
Last year there were heckles during his speech. I think today showed that really the atmosphere is quite different. It's perhaps a little flat, the atmosphere, I think people would say. But at the same time, it's not that those kind of internal tensions in the party aren't coming to the fore in the same way. And I think the leadership will be very pleased about how that went off without a hitch, that singing the national anthem, because, again, it's about signalling to the country Labour has changed, it's ready for government.
People in Italy are voting in a general election which is expected to deliver the country's first female prime minister. Opinion polls suggest that Giorgia Meloni's far-right Brothers of Italy party could form a coalition with other right-wing or anti-immigrant parties. In the last election, she polled just 4% of votes, but Italy's former ambassador to NATO, Stefano Stefanini, says people are ready for change.
Too many Italians have been hit by 20 years of economic stagnation, in which we've had centre-right government, centre-left government, technocratic governments, and except Draghi government, there's been very little economic progress. So they're looking for alternatives. The alternative on the table now is Giorgia Meloni with the Brothers of Italy, and that's why so many votes are going to her.
Humberside police have arrested a 17-year-old after 11 people were hurt at a gathering of car owners in Scunthorpe. One person is in a critical but stable condition. A 10-year-old boy is being treated in a hospital for serious injuries after falling from a height while visiting Ovingdean near Brighton. A roundabout was closed while the boy was rescued. One of the founding members of Pink Floyd, Roger Waters, has had two concerts in Poland next year cancelled after he criticised Ukraine's handling of the Russian invasion. In an open letter, he said President Zelensky had failed to bring peace to the east of the country and the West was fueling the conflict by arming Ukraine. From Warsaw, here's Adam Easton.
Roger Waters was due to play two shows in Kraków next April, but their promoters, Live Nation Poland, and the venue itself announced they had been cancelled. They gave no reason for the cancellation, but the decision comes after a city councillor urged people to boycott the concerts. The city council is due to vote in a few days on a resolution declaring Mr. Waters persona non grata. Councillors said they were outraged by the 79-year-old musician's comments, given what they described as Russia's criminal attack on Ukraine and mounting evidence of Russian